and welcome to Design and Business Conversations for Creatives. I'm Cheyney, and today I'm going to be sharing with you my Society6 process. In this video, I will share a screen recording where I expose my process and hopefully help you to make some sales. I've started including the timestamps in all my description boxes below. You can also find any links that I mention in this video, and be sure to check out my other videos if you're interested in all things design and business. I'm going to show you my complete Society6 process, from creating my artwork, turning it into a seamless pattern design on Adobe Illustrator, and then uploading it into Society6, including dimensions and specs. If you don't use Adobe Illustrator for your artwork for Society6, this first part of the video won't be relevant to you. Just go down to the description box and click the timestamps below. I'll separate the video so you can just get to the exact information that you need. If you are an Adobe Illustrator person and you don't know how to make seamless pattern designs, this is a quick tutorial of how I do it. If you do find this part of the video interesting or useful, please let me know in the comments, because screen recording and audio, this is the first time I've ever done it, but it's something that I can do more of if you find it helpful. I drew this tulip on my iPad Pro using my Apple Pencil on Adobe Draw. If you have a Creative Cloud subscription and that's how you use Illustrator, Adobe Draw will come with that. And if you have an iPad, it's free to download. I highly, highly recommend that you get onto it. Also, an Apple Pencil is amazing. It's been an absolute game changer for me. The reason why I like Adobe Draw over Procreate, a lot of people will use Procreate, is that it actually turns the artwork into vector artwork, and you can import it directly into Illustrator, and it's just been an absolute game changer, because I used to use the pen tool. I love the pen tool, and this is just honestly saved me so much time, because I can just use my pencil and everything's converted to vector artwork, and it's super, super easy. So how I create seamless patterns is I will grab my artwork here. I have my artboard, which is a shift O 8192 points by 8192 points, which is a little bit of a random size, but anyway, it's the biggest that Adobe Draw will allow me to have my artboard. So I have it on that on my iPad, because sometimes I will upload my artwork directly from my iPad onto Society6, and it's big enough to cover most products. However, it won't cover curtains and duffel bags, and there's a couple of other products that it won't. But if I upload it and I'm on the go, say I'm visiting my family down in Wellington, I can take my iPad and I can upload on the go. What I want to do is I want to get this into a seamless pattern. And I'll do my best to explain this, but anyway, I have my snapping on here. This mustard rectangle is exactly the same size as my artboard, and I need to make sure that it's centered, aligned to artboard, center it. Yep, perfect. And this is just all going to happen quite quickly and easily with snapping on. I'll show you after this how I test it out to make sure everything works. So just going to bring it up here, and it's going to snap, match up the arrows in pink, and that should be right on that corner. Then I'm going to duplicate the flower and drag it, holding shift all the way to the other corner, so I know that I need to work within the space. So then I'm just going to duplicate these flowers, holding down option shift, and then Apple D, duplicate it, select all, align to selection this time, and horizontal distribution. So there we have our first row. I'm going to go ahead and group it, and then option until that double arrow comes down. I can pull it down like that, but I want it in a straight line, so I'll hold down shift and match up that black cross with the center cross. Easy, easy, easy. Do that again, drag it down and snap to the bottom. So I want these off the artboard. So essentially this corner here needs to match up with this corner here. I want some in the middle, but I actually want three. I want them to stagger. So I could just keep it at four, move it up, but I actually want it as three. So I'm gonna ungroup it, get rid of one. Get rid of one, group the rest, and then center it to the artboard this time. Like that. So there we go. I want to make sure these are even. So again, I'm going to go through group. I'm sure there's an easy way to do that. Make sure these are all grouped. Select them all and then align to selection.
So I want to distribute vertically. You'll see that came down a little bit, and those should be all evenly spaced. Group them all and then make sure they're aligned to center and horizontal, which they are. But now I need to crop them. So I do this with a clipping mask. So I just take the back, duplicate it, object, arrange, bring to front, align to artboard, center it, and then hold down shift, select the flower pattern and the square, and then command 7, which is clipping mask, which you can do up here as well in object clipping mask make. So then I'm going to group those, scale them down until they pop, snap, and then duplicate, and then duplicate again. And that should be all perfect. Let's test it out. Let's get right in there. Yep, that is seamless. I could continue that process forever and ever if I wanted. I could take that down. You know, I can kind of make the pattern as big or as little as I want. But I do like it that size. So what I'm going to do now is file save, and then I'm going to export it, file export, export as, and I export for Society6, I export as a PNG and at 200 ppi. So it defaults to screen at 72. There is medium, but I found that 200 is the best. 300 will never save. It lags and it takes forever to save, and I don't know how much difference it makes, but I have found that this is the way. White or transparent, it doesn't matter because it has a background. And I click OK. So once that saves and I have a position for it right here, it's on my desktop, I click sell. So I will go into the Artist Studio. Last time I did a video, I was kind of bagging the Artist Studio and was saying that I always go back to old Artist Studio, and I still do this, but not with patterns. I find with patterns, this one here is absolutely fine. With this dot drawing of a shark, I would have used the old studio. Go up here and add new artwork. So once I click add new artwork, I can select the file, it's on my desktop, drag it straight in, and this should be big enough to cover all the products. Say if I was just to upload the flower, I would have to resize it for different products, but having a pattern is really handy. And what I really like about is the wallpaper, because this is seamless, this could legitimately be a wallpaper that will wallpaper an entire house with no mismatched seams, and the designer in me loves that. So anyway, upload that and enter a title. For me, this is a minimal Scandinavian. Oh, you get a little insight into how I spell. I have to say things phonetically to spell them properly. Anyway, minimal Scandinavian tulip flower motif repeat pattern. So then I'm going to go continue. I represent, yes, does not contain mature artwork, continue. So while this is all uploading, because it can take quite a while, go down graphic design, digital, pattern, and then those don't really work. So I kind of start with the tags. A lot of people will do a lot of research with tags, but I haven't found in Society6 that it matters for me. My work, for whatever reason, is being seen on Society6 over any other print-on-demand website that I'm on. So this is what works for me. I just kind of write exactly what it is and think, okay, so who is going to be wanting this design? Probably someone who is into Scandi style. So that might be a keyword. Scandinavian inspired flower, floral, flowers, mustard, minimal, aesthetic, it's contemporary, it's bright, put home decor. I think that people who are interested in home decor would be interested in this pattern. You have to think of the user and what are they going to type into Society6 when they're looking for artwork. Are they going to say floral pattern wall art or fun flower drawing? So drawings, one drawing, illustration, modern. So you get up to 20 keywords, and I suggest you use all of them. Wall art, Remember, because of the mustard retro seamless pattern. Take the title, select all, Apple A, and then copy, Apple C, copy V, minimal Scandinavian shirt, and then I might add inspired in there. So you want to make this a sentence that makes sense, but also contains keywords that are key to your artwork. So minimal Scandinavian inspired tulip flower motif repeat pattern. Seamless repeat pattern designed in Auckland, New Zealand by Design by Cheyney. So that's just if anyone searches Design by Cheyney, it can be linked back to here. Save details. I represent that everything is mine. And then I'm just going to go through and turn everything on. And a reason why I don't like this new Artist Studio, and you can always toggle back to the old one, is sometimes the buttons kind of toggle on or off. You see that happened up there? They're a bit tricky like that, but I think, yep, see? There's a lag. If you just be patient, they will toggle back, so just click them once, but we can always go back and check them. So my process is I just go and turn everything on, make sure everything looks good. And obviously you can go in and edit and you can scale things up or down and move them, but because it's a repeatable pattern, super easy, it just goes onto everything, no drama, fuss-free, great, love it, perfect. Okay, I already want that travel mark. So once I've toggled them all on, I just scroll back up and check that they're all on. The leggings, for whatever reason, take forever to show up, but because it's a seamless pattern, I know it's going to be absolutely fine. I trust that will look good. Some of these are really cute. Look at this top. Everything's on. And that's it. And all I do is publish artwork and boom, another one in the store. So if I go view my shop, I now have 119 designs. Easy as that. Took me under half an hour. I don't always do patterns, as you can see, but repeat patterns have been really popular for me and I find them very easy to upload. So I hope this was helpful, and if you want to see anything else, just let me know in the comments and I'll see what I can do.
I hope this has been helpful for you. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up or subscribe using the button below. Hit the notifications bell and be sure to check out my other videos. If you like this one, have a good day. Bye.